when I was a younger person, I was looking for narratives to believe in that kind of, well, this is, you know, subconscious, of course. I'm looking for narratives to believe in that kind of gel with my own personal values that I had, right? So the thing that I began to gravitate towards were the rappers that not only explained the socio-political aspect of being a young black person in the hood and the drug thing and all this stuff that's going on around us, but that there was a way out of that based on, you know, these systematic choices that you would make.
As you being older,
yeah,
and you having the circle of friends, what made y'all in that group? Was it because some of y'all were already down with the teachers of the five percenters in the nation and like having that strong foundation?
No, it's an aspect of, I think it's, you know, and it's just, this is my personal belief, and we can bust this up or whatever. I think like everything boils down to personal choice, and personal choice boils down to personal perspective. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? In a sense of like, you know, I wanted to believe that reason why, because I was looking for a reason, like, you know, why my parents fucked up on the drugs and shit. You know what I mean? Why does it seem like there's only a handful of choices of us out here? Either we get busy in the streets in that economy, you know what I'm saying? Or like, why shit then got limited like this? Mm-hmm. And then somebody, because both, if you look at NWA and the Public Enemy, both of them broke down the socio-political reasons of why we were teenagers in that time period. But then it's like, you know, it's like I believed, you know, my mother raised me in the church. So I was, you know, I wasn't never a dumb nigga. So I'm scripturally wise. You know what I'm saying? So I always believed in a higher power. I always believed in God. I always believed in, at the end of the day, God got a solution for all of this. So if I already accepted it as a belief, somebody riding in on like, yeah, God got a solution. The solution is black people, the original people from the planet. Yeah. And we went through this shit as a test. But, you know, I mean, we're going to come on the other side as victorious. Oh, sign me up. Yeah, that was easy for me to believe. But my dudes that believed in the hopelessness of things, like, man, shit ain't never, I don't give a fuck how black you get, nigga. Right. Niggas is always going to be niggas, nigga. That's niggas it. Just going to die, nigga. And I'm going to be a nigga for life. That made sense to some of my niggas.
Sometimes, like, you can't let other people or other things create your story.
Yes.
Mm. And it's like somebody can give you two choices and say, this is the only way you can be this thing that you feel like you should be. Mm-hmm. And maybe, let's say it's a career move. Mm-hmm. This person said, you gotta get your master's degree to do that. This person say, you can get your bachelor's, but then you gotta da-da-da-da-da. You gotta put in this many hours, you could do this. And then if you feel like you can't or have no interest in doing those two things, what if somebody introduced you to Google and YouTube and you can create this business for yourself? But some people don't look for that other role. Yeah. It's like, but this is what they said.
Yeah.
This is what they said I have. This is what I have to choose from. And that's it. And I so wasn't. You just sit there and do nothing because that's what people told you. We talk.